We are following breaking news right now. Evacuation orders are in effect in Estes Park as the Fern Lake fire continues to grow at this hour. High winds overnight prompting early morning evacuations. And we have a map right now to show you the area we're talking about in Rocky Mountain National Park. A press conference, in fact, just wrapped up at the Beaver Meadows Visitor Center. This is the park's headquarters. And this is on Highway 36 near the entrance of Rocky Mountain National Park in Estes Park. And right now, we have Tracy Weaver from Rocky Mountain National Park to join us with the latest. She was just at the press conference. Hi, Tracy. Thank you for joining us this morning.
Good morning.
So I understand one structure is lost so far?
That's right. The fire has remained on park property. We had one cabin lost early this morning.
How big is the fire right now?
We don't have an updated acreage as of yet. Once we're able to get folks up in the air and map the fire, we'll have a little better idea how much growth we experienced last night.
We talk about evacuations. Do you know how many people are affected?
I know that over 200 folks showed up at the evacuation center, which is the high school here in Estes Park. The Larimer County Sheriff's Department is coordinating that.
Okay, and I understand the fire obviously big enough that the Holiday Home Tour, which is a huge fundraising event up there that's been canceled because one of the houses is within the evacuation area and also just the smoke in that area. Can you talk a little bit about visibility there?
The smoke was really heavy overnight. When the winds died down a little bit early this morning, that helped a little bit. We're getting a little bit more lift with our smoke, so it's not settling into Estes Park quite as bad as it was earlier.
What about the number of crews actually on site right now fighting the fire? I understand more hotshot crews are on their way.
We do have, we had 60 folks assigned to the fire as of last night, and then we placed orders for two hotshot crews last night. We ordered two more this morning. We've ordered several structure protection engines, mostly provided by fire departments in the area, that came in as early. The Estes Park Fire Department was out at 2:30 this morning, helping support the effort. We've also ordered two more Type 1 helicopters, and we have two air tankers flying this way. Should be here within a couple hours.
And we've been, of course, following updates on Twitter as well from Red Cross saying that there are about 50 people who are at the Estes Park High School. This is the evacuation center that's being set up. Are you hearing anything more about that as well? I'm assuming it's going to stay open at least for the rest of the day, maybe even into tomorrow.
It will stay open as long as necessary until we can get folks back in their home.
So the conditions right now that you're seeing there, what kind of challenges are firefighters facing in trying to put this blaze out?
What we've been facing all along with this fire is it's just critically dry fuels, very receptive fuels for fire spread. So last night the fire was actually spotting, throwing embers out a mile in front of itself and starting new fires. So that just speaks to the extreme conditions that we have. As far as dryness and the weather, the wind last night was gusting up to 75 miles an hour, which is just incredible. And where this fire started, and most of the fire has been in very steep, very rugged terrain with a lot of beetle kill hazard trees that would make it difficult for firefighters on the ground.
And we were getting word that there were some people evacuated from a campsite because of the fire danger.
The Marine Park campground was evacuated at just before 2 a.m. this morning. There were not a lot of people camping there at this time of year. Fewer than 20 people were evacuated.
We're showing video. I'm assuming you can't see it right now, Tracy, a video that we shot back from when the fire actually first started in October, and you could see the heavy smoke and the conditions. It sounds like it's still the same right now. But the good news, as you mentioned, the wind has really died down for the most part compared to early this morning and last night, of course.
Right. We're still getting some pretty strong gusts, but nothing like the 75-mile-an-hour gusts that were hitting last night.
Okay. Well, Tracy Weaver, thank you from Rocky Mountain National Park. Thank you for the update. We certainly appreciate that. Again, one cabin lost so far. There are a few people evacuated from a campsite that was nearby. More hotshot crews are coming in today to help fight this fire. No exact word right now as far as how big the fire has grown so far, but We are getting updates by the hour, by the minute, in fact. And this picture you're looking at, we just got this in from photojournalist Major King. He, too, was at the press conference that just wrapped up at Beaver Meadows Visitor Center. Here's another one you see right there. I'm assuming police, they're blocking off roads, of course, to try to keep the area safe. And you can see the smoke in the background. We talked about that before as well, talking about how the wind has died down. That's why the smoke is more visible, which that is a good news there, that the smoke, I mean, that the wind that has died down, but you can obviously see the smoke. It's settled in some. And I apologize, this picture is coming in from Frank Lancaster right there. Thank you so much for sending that in. We appreciate it. You can see the heavy smoke just coming from this fire. Again, the Fern Lake fire burning still at this hour, growing. This is near Estes Park. If you're just joining us, there have been evacuations in order. I believe about 600 people to last count, 600 evacuation notices sent out this morning because the fire continues to grow. Firefighters are trying to get the upper hand on this fire right now. More hotshot crews are on the way. We've been talking about the extreme drought condition, of course, that's been going on. It's continuing. We need help from Mother Nature as far as moisture goes. So what you're looking at right now, this is a fire evacuation areas. The areas affected, Highway 66 and all adjacent streets, including the YMCA, High Drive and all adjacent streets as well, Mary's Lake Road up to Moraine Avenue to Mary's Lake. This is on the west side, okay? Well, evacuees should meet at Estes Park High School. That is the evacuation center set up right now. This is at 1600 Manford Avenue in Estes Park. If you have large animals, you can take them to Stanley Park Fairgrounds. This is at 1209 Manford Avenue. So meteorologist Maureen McCann, she's been watching, of course, the weather closely, especially with the Fern Lake fire. Maureen, we need some help. And as we've been talking about, the wind continues up there, but it's dying down for the most part, right?
Yeah, no more 75 mile per hour gusts like we heard Tracy talking about, Christine. But we're seeing our camera on the roof of the Stanley Hotel shake a little bit with the breeze, and that has been up to still about 20 to 30 miles per hour in the area. But looking at this picture, I've been watching this all morning, and you can actually see some of the mountains in the background there. This was covered by smoke in the past few hours, so that's a sign they're getting a little more mixing, and that smoke is starting to elevate a little bit. And Tracy was also mentioning that it's going to be blustery there today, but not quite warning criteria. We don't have any fire weather alerts posted around the region or any wind advisories. In fact, the current wind gusts coming in from this chart showing Estes Park only at 8 miles per hour, but it's going to be the higher peaks that see the stronger gusts, and then those are going to be primarily with the westerly component today, and that's going to help drive up the wind speed. So our computer model guidance from a localized view of Estes Park shows the contours with the stronger winds in the elevated terrain. But the gusts today should likely be a below warning criteria, and they will still be mustering into the overnight hours too, but again, 15 to 20 miles per hour on average. Wish I had some better news in terms of some moisture coming into this part of the state. Other than a flurry or two in the highest peaks, we don't have much coming in today. So dry and breezy for the Estes Park area and Rocky Mountain National Park for the balance of this weekend. As we go into the start of December, we have one sign that we could get some moisture here by tomorrow night into Monday. But the overall trend is that we have dry conditions across all of Colorado for this first weekend in December. So your hourly planner for today back here in the metro area, checking in with our forecast, very warm. We're talking about almost 20 degrees above the average, but it is going to be breezy. Those stronger wind gusts are over with, but we do anticipate for the breeze to still be around 30 to 40 miles per hour in those highest peaks in Rocky Mountain National Park. And then we'll be watching the future cast really closely for perhaps some moisture to come in tomorrow night into Monday. We'll keep you posted on that. Christine.